गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. नाउ इन टूडेज क्लास विल बी स्टडिंग द नेक्स्ट अप्रोच टू लेआउट डिजाइन, दैट इज काइजन. नाउ फर्स्ट यू क्लियरली अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड काइजन. नाउ हियर दे हैव गिवन एज व्हाट, चेंज फॉर बेटर एंड कंटिन्यूअस इम्प्रूवमेंट. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दीज टू की वर्ड, सो क्लियरली यू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट डू मीन बाय काइजन. चेंज फॉर बेटर मीन्स वॉट? नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू द advancement in the science and technology, okay, some kind of changes should be brought or implemented in the organization. The company should not only make use of the old techniques or old technology which is there, okay, some new things or some new innovative things means new innovative products can be brought, okay, new process of production. So these all can be implemented in the organization. Change for better. Now, for what purposes these changes have been brought? Changes have been brought for the betterment, okay, or improvement of the company or organization. Now, what all changes can be brought? Changes can be brought regarding, there can be the technological changes, okay, then social changes can be there, political changes. So, all these such kind of changes should be brought in the company. It is for the betterment or it is for the improvement in the company. So change for better and continuous improvement. Continuous improvement means what? Nowadays you can see that new things or new technology will be there, okay, so according to that the continuously improvement should be brought in the company. So that is called as a kaizen, means change for better and continuous improvement. Now based on that we will be studying about the advantages. In that, first one is what? Continuous inspection. Continuous inspection means what? Okay, see, inspection is continuous checking or inspection of the products has to be done. Like suppose when they find that there is a low quality product, okay, if they check continuously or properly they try to inspect, that time only they'll come to understand that what defect or what damage is there in that particular product, okay. Like suppose, I will give you one simple example here. Now, without doing proper inspection or without doing checking, like that way only they will try to send the goods to the other company. And afterwards, the other company which is there or customers who are there, okay, they will try to find out some defect or damage in that particular product. Now, why this happened? This happened because no proper inspection or checking was being done. So, it is the responsibility of the company that before sending the goods to the customer, okay, what they need to do, proper checking or proper inspection about that particular products has to be done, whether the goods are in a proper condition or not, and afterwards only the goods should be sent to the customer. The next one is increase efficiency, productivity, okay. Now here few terms you need to remember that, okay, like a few terms are there, that is space utilization, product quality, communication and employee retention. Now we'll understand each term clearly. Space utilization. Space utilization means what? See, how much area or how much space is required in order to manufacture that particular product, okay, whether it will cover more space or less space, depending upon, okay, how the product means, depending upon that which type of product has to be manufactured, that is a space utilization, means the area covered, how much space or how much area is used in order to manufacture or in order to carry on that manufacturing process. Then after that, product quality also, whether the proper quality of products is been there or no. Then communication and employee retention. See, there should be a proper flow of communication. And what do you mean by employee retention? See here, this term you need to understand that employee retention means what? How to make the employees retain or stay permanently in the organization so that they should not leave the company and go to the other company. So these all terms you need to remember, increase efficiency, productivity. The next one is what? Provides immediate result. okay, they should get the fast outcome or quick result. Okay, now this is possible that now whenever the manufacturing process takes place, we should get a quick result or immediate result. The next one is what? Improve process. Now here they should not only try to improve the products which are there, but also make some improvement in the process of production. Like usually what happens, we had studied before how the product will be manufactured, right? From the stage of collection of raw material, then work in progress and finished goods. There some improvement in the process of production has to be done. Then the next one is what? Employee satisfaction. Now what do you mean by employee satisfaction? See here, now whether to know that whether employees are satisfied with their job or not. Basically, the employees will be satisfied with the salary, whether they are getting the sufficient salary with where they are working in the company, okay, and whether the good working conditions have been provided to them. These all things are there which makes the employee feel satisfied at a particular job, because employee, when he is working in that workplace or job, he should be self-satisfied. Okay, if he is not satisfied working in that company, no, he will not give the good result. When he is satisfied working in that particular company, then only he can yield or give the good result. So this is all about Kaizen. Only you need to remember Kaizen means what? Okay, continuous improvement, okay, and the change for the better. Some changes can be done which will help for the betterment or improvement in the organization. Based on what? The advancement in the science and technology. Then the next one of the new approach to layout design is services layout. Now what do you mean by services layout? Means rendering the good services. Okay, here some terms are there regarding the personnel, communication, infrastructure and material involvement. So here what happens? In services layout, how good services have been rendered or provided to the customer, okay, and there should be a proper flow of communication, okay, there should be a proper flow of communication and providing proper infrastructural facilities and material involvement. Now here we can study about the objectives of services layout. In that, first one is what? Ensuring easy comfort to the customer. Now what do you mean by ensuring easy comfort to the customer? Now see here, you have to link that to the services. So here, whenever the services are provided to the customer, means here the customer should be feel comfortable in order to purchase that particular product. Then influencing and making a request to the customer. Now here in services layout, we will take one simple example that now there is one salesman, he want to render the service to the customer. Influencing the customer and making a request to the customer in order to purchase that particular product. Okay, means here convincing skill should be there. He need to influence or convince the customer or request the customer in order to purchase his particular product. Then exhibiting the goods in an effective manner. Now here, whatever the goods have been there, okay, providing whatever goods are there, that should be done in a proper manner. Then reducing travel time of customer. Okay, now the traveling time of the customer also will be reduced, because what happens, see, different areas are there or different location are there, and how the targeting will be done, target a customer. Okay, so they will make a target or group of people or customer, okay, and try to target only those particular customer. So that time what happens, the traveling time of the customer will be reduced. And there should be a proper communication and coordination between different work areas should be enhanced. Means here they should provide a proper communication. Okay, as I've told you, there should be a proper flow of communication. Okay, and not only communication is important, plus there should be a proper coordination also. If the workers are working in one department, okay, and there is no coordination among the workers, then it is not possible for them to give the good result. So because of that, there should be a proper coordination among the workers. Then rotation of stock to enhance the life of the product. Now here, the rotation of the stock to enhance the life of the product. Now see here, different products are there, their life which is there, okay, it will be different. It will exist for a certain time or certain duration. So the rotation of stock will be done. So this is all about the services layout. And today's class we had studied about the this one, Kaizen, then its advantages and services layout, its objectives. Only you need to remember Kaizen means what? Now here, something change for the better and continuous improvement. Change will be done for the betterment or improvement of the company, and there should be a continuous improvement. And services layout, okay, how the services will be rendered or provided to the customer, okay, and based on that we have studied the different advantages and objective. So these are the next two types of new approaches to layout design.